Welcome to Super at 60. I'm Darlene. I'm so happy to have you in my home, and I'm thrilled to have you in my kitchen today. Welcome to everyone to this fantastic Crocktober extravaganza. I have been waiting for my day, and I have been watching all the other fantastic videos. If you missed some of them, you can just look below, and I have a link down there, and you can go and catch all the ones that you haven't seen. And then you can also see all the ones who are coming after me, like tomorrow and all till the end, till the 31st. Jenny Gaw, I think it's Gaw, is putting this together. And at the end of Crocktober, that means October 31st, I hope that you will have gone to each and every one of the videos and given them a like and subscribe if you'd like to. And press that little button. We always have to press that little button. And just leave a little comment. It was so good. Really like that, blah, blah, blah. You know, just leave a little comment and you will do that same with my video. And I hope that you will subscribe because we'd love to have you here at Super at 60. We have an awful lot of fun. And she's gonna pick a winner, and guess what you're gonna win? You could win a brand new crock pot, a brand new crock pot. I want a brand new crock pot. In fact, the one that I'm using today, I'm staring at it right now. It's pretty old. I mean, it is so old. I scrubbed it up really well this morning. I use them all the time. I have four of them, and I do use them all the time, kind of interchangeably. This is the one I believe that has both handles. I have one that has actually, this is the one with just one handle. I have a crock pot with a little bit of a handicap. So, but it still works, you know, it still works. So it's okay. Anyway, hey, you know what we're making today? We are making Halloween hash. Ooh. This is the meal. This is the meal that you want to serve to your family October 31st. Serve it early for those little ghosts and goblins that you may have in your house. Make sure that you have this recipe in your crock pot, hot and ready to go. Like I was saying, around 5 o'clock. Yeah. And make sure that your little ghosts and goblins eat a good, warm, yummy dinner. They will love, love, love this dish. And so will you, by the way. And you want to send them out with nice full tummies so that they're not stopping at every single house and looking through their little pumpkin basket and sneaking a little piece of candy. So by the time they get home, their tummies are full of candy, and sometimes they're sick, miserable from it all, and you know, it can be a mess. My boys are all grown now, and I have three little grandchildren. Yes, three of them under the age of three. So my oldest grandson will be going out, and I'm sure he'll have a nice warm dinner before he goes out, but that is the best thing that you can do for your little kids. So I hope that you'll serve them Halloween hash and make it a regular yearly thing. Guess what? It's Halloween hash tonight, guys. Oh, yay, we love it. I hope that's what happens. Is what I'm hoping for your family. So let's turn around now, and we are going to begin our Halloween hash. We're going to start over there on the stove, and then we're going to end up with my little one-armed crock pot. See you later. Okay, we are going to begin by browning up 1 pound of hamburger. Any kind of hamburger you like is fine. I generally buy a block of the organic hamburger. I just prefer that. I think it just tastes better to me, but there are many times when I just buy the regular hamburger at the grocery store as well. Yeah, it's getting harder to find meat, isn't it? I went to the grocery store yesterday. They did have a good deal on some chicken thighs, and I did pick them up. I think they were like $1.19 a pound, but as far as the ground beef went, so whenever it's on sale, and I'm talking Aldi, I usually grab it, as many as I can, and I put it in my freezer. So, all right, as soon as I get this browned up, and I'm also going to get the excessive grease off of here, because I don't want that in here. That'll take me just a few minutes. I'll be back, and I'll show you the rest of the ingredients. All right. Everything's all nice and browned up. I'm going to turn this down a little bit because it's kind of high. I got a lot of the grease off. I just take a pair of tongs and some paper towels, and it sucks it up right away, and I throw it right into my trash can. Don't even have to touch the trash can. It's a wonderful way to do that. All right, and now, just move your meat to the side a little bit. I'm going to add a half a cup of chopped onions. Just soften them up a little bit. Yeah, it won't take long. Start mixing it all together. Just take a big old fry pan, and you can get this down pretty quickly. And now I'm going to add in one can of cheddar cheese soup. You know, I thought at first that this, years ago, that this would be hard to find because I had never used it before. But it's not. It is not hard to find. You can get it in your grocery store. The only place where you cannot get it, at least at mine, is Aldi. Unfortunately, they have cream of mushroom. They have plenty of cream of chicken. But none of this. None of the specialty cream soups. That you're going to have to stop in one of your bigger grocery store chains. And that's fine. We have plenty of grocery stores around where we live. So that's generally not a problem. Alright, so in that goes. And then, let me stir that up a little bit. Alright, yeah, it's quieting down a little bit. Isn't that better? Good. Perfect. Remember, all of this is going to be dumped into the crock pot for a few hours. Oh my goodness. I want to eat this right now for lunch. Alright, and guess what this is? Yeah, this is sweet relish, and we're going to put that right in. And that's a quarter of a cup. I will have the recipe for this below for you, because I know that's important. 2 tablespoons of Dijon mustard, or brown mustard of your choice. You know what? If you don't have this and you'd really like to try this, but you have everything else, all you have is good old yellow mustard, please use that, because I have done that before. And it is absolutely delicious. As a matter of fact, as I was making this, putting it all together, I thought, you know what? Whoops. Maybe I'll mix like half and half of the mustards. You could do that. You could easily do that. You can see how easy this is to put together. All right, and you mix that all together. And do this on a nice low heat. Because once that hamburger is done, all the rest of these things are going to cook in that crock pot for a couple hours, a few hours. All right, you need 2 tablespoons of ketchup. Whoops. Now, when you get your ketchup out, get your 2 tablespoons for right now, go ahead and leave it out, because when the Halloween hash is done, you're going to want that ketchup to finish it off when you serve it. And one tablespoon of Worcestershire sauce. I always think that makes the meat, whatever meat you use, I just think it makes it taste more steak-like, a little bit better quality. And I think that's why they put it in here. Oh, doesn't that look yummy? Wouldn't you like to have this over a hamburger bun right now? I think it looks great. All right, I'm gonna mix it up really, really well. And I will meet you back at the crock pot, the one-armed crock pot. I am now back over at my counter. I have my crock pot turned on low. I always like to turn my crock pot on while I'm getting things ready for my crock pot meals, whether it's soups or stews or chilies or this wonderful Halloween hash, whatever it is, turn it on so it is ready to prepare all the things that you want to put in there. It just works. And I do have it set on low because that's what I'm going to have my settings on. And I'm also going to spray it. Yep, I'm going to spray it really, really well. You can use a liner bag if you'd like to. But for this one, I'm just going to spray it. All right, let me go ahead and spray my crock pot. There, that should be good. All right, we are gonna begin now with adding some hash browns, some frozen hash browns. Mine are frozen and they always work fine that way. That's the way I do it. This is the country style shredded potatoes. I'm gonna take a peek at that. And this is a 30 ounce bag. Okay, so let me open it up. And we're gonna do a lot of half and half right now. I'm just gonna kinda guesstimate, if you will, half of the potatoes. I'd say that's about half, okay? All right, go ahead and spread them out, just like that. And now we're gonna add half of the meat mixture. I went ahead and divided it in my pan. Just go ahead and sprinkle it around right on top of your taters. Oh my goodness. Can you even imagine how good this is? I know y'all are sitting there going, oh my gracious. Halloween hash for this Halloween, guys. Yeah. I don't know. I must be hungry today. I think I'm hungry. I don't even know what time it is. I think it's past lunchtime. So anyway, all right, there we go. Okay, and on top of that, I'm gonna add two cups of shredded cheddar cheese. All right, and get that nice and even right on top. Oh, it's just all those things that we put into the meat mixture that smells so good. Oh, excellent. All right, I'm gonna spread that around just a little bit, just layering and layering. Now we wanna add 1 teaspoon of salt and 1/2 teaspoon of pepper. And all I did, you're only gonna wanna add half of this mixture right now. So I went ahead, put it all in here, mixed it all up really, really well. And I'm just gonna go ahead and sprinkle half. Okay, and the rest of it will go on the second layer, which I'm starting right now. I'm gonna add the rest of the potatoes. This is our second layer. Okay, just use your impeccably clean mama hands. Okay, that will be just fine. A little bit of potato skins there. All right, and now just spread out the rest of that luscious meat mixture. I gotta tell ya, this smells so good. Okay. Yeah, I hum a lot. Sorry. There we go. All right, that looks so good. Oh my goodness, I love stacked stuff like this. You know, it makes for such a nice meal, and it's really great when it comes out. Oh, and you get to see all the layers. Yeah, I love cooking, I really do. Okay, I'm gonna get this last tablespoon in here. I do not wanna leave any behind. Get rid of my pan. All right, so I think I have used just about everything, except I'm gonna top it off here with another 1/2 cup of the shredded cheddar cheese. Oh my goodness. Can you smell it? Can you smell it? It smells so good. And I'm gonna put on the rest of that salt and pepper. And this time, I think I'm gonna put it in my hands and just sprinkle it a little bit like that, okay? You know what, I'm just gonna tell you a little interesting tidbit here. When you go to the refrigerator and you pull out your Worcestershire sauce bottle, make sure that before you use it, in no matter what you're using it, it tastes good. Make sure that you shake up that bottle really well, because if you take it out of the refrigerator and you turn it upside down, always keep your finger on the cap, of course, you'll see that there's a lot of stuff there. There's a lot of sediment that happens while it sits. So shake it up really, really well and then use it. Okay, guess what? We are ready to put the lid on. The crock pot is already on, and that's that. And I'll see you in about 4 hours. Now, if you don't have that much time, you can set it on high for about 2 hours, okay? All right, this works no matter what your needs are. This Halloween hash works really, really well. Like our Halloween hash is all done. I have waited 4 hours. Actually, you know what? I take that back. When I checked on it at 3 hours, it was looking pretty darn good. So yeah, I would check on it at about 3 hours and it should be perfect. You can either turn it down on low or just turn it on warm, not on low, on warm. And then, or you can turn it off, just leave the lid on and it will stay hot for a good long time. So don't worry about that. All right, are you ready to see it? Are you ready to see the plate that I have prepared for you? Not only have I put my Halloween hash on here, but I've put a few other ideas on here that you might wanna serve Halloween night to your little ones, to your whole family. You'll love it too, I promise you will. All right, there it is, look at this plate. Oh, look at that Halloween hash. Melted cheese on top. Oh, that beautiful hamburger meat and all those delicious things that we added in there. The pickle, the relish. Oh, it's just fantastic. The mustard, the ketchup. It smells like $1 million in here. In fact, my husband Lou just walked through the door and coming home from work and he said, it sure smells good in there. First thing you said, oh, hi, Darlene. But that's okay. See, I take that as a compliment. So there we go, round and round. And my other idea, look at this, my homemade coleslaw. I will put that recipe below if you'd like to have it. A beautiful speared dill pickle. Oh, what would be better than that with this? And look, how sweet. A sweet little strawberry fan your little trick-or-treaters will absolutely love. Yes, you fill their tummies with all these delicious things, especially the star of the show, our Halloween hash. Yep, you fill their tummies with all of these yummy things on Halloween night, and they will ask for it year after year after year. You may even have to make it a couple times during the year, you know, before next October 31st on Halloween. Well, I want to thank you all so much for being here with me, Super at 60. I'm Darlene. It has been absolutely fantastic for me to participate in this Crock-Pot extravaganza. Remember, go visit all of the wonderful channels that have participated in this Crock-Pot extravaganza. Leave me a comment below. Please leave me a comment below. And if you enjoyed the video today, press the like button, and I would so love for you to please join us here and just press that button to subscribe and press that little bell so you know when my videos come out, and they come out all the time. Yeah, they do. I make all kinds of things. We do all kinds of stuff here, and you'll have a good time. You really will. So I will say to you now, bye-bye, and Lord bless.